adventurers. We are here in lovely York. We are actually going to go out and explore today. Yesterday was a bit rainy, so we just stayed in and got some work done. But today, I mean, it's still a little cloudy, but I think it's going to be a little bit warmer than it has been. But first, before we go out, we wanted to show you this amazing place that we're staying in. We have this huge open area, and apparently this place used to be an old barn or stables, and she converted it into this place, and then there's another little room next door, and then she has a little cottage on site, and then her and her family live here. It's really cool.
What I love the most about this space is, even though it's kind of a dreary day outside, you have these three different skylights at the top, so you always get a ton of light in here, which is awesome, especially for England, because the weather can be a bit dreary sometimes. And then we have this amazing looking kitchen, super white and pristine, which is nice. And my favorite part of this kitchen is this amazing refrigerator. Look at this thing. It's so classy and retro. Isn't that sweet? I like that a lot. These couches are super classy, you guys. It's like this aged leather. I didn't really think I liked leather, but this is really nice. It's really comfortable.
All right, now let's head down to the bedroom. This place is so cool. It's almost like a tiny house or something because it's so compact, but it feels so spacious. Look at this amazing bedroom. We have been staying in hostels recently, which are really cool and really affordable, but I'm over bunk beds. And now we have this luxurious four-post bed, and the mattress is amazing, and there's this huge down comforter so we can snuggle up at night. I think we're gonna go see some awesome sights, and there are tons of things to see in and outside of York. Castles, the coast, all kinds of amazing walks, delicious food, obviously, and a Christmas market. So we gotta fit it all in. We're only here for a few days, I think three more days. So we gotta get going.
This place is so dang charming, you guys. This is why we love exploring England, because whether it's dreary out or not, just if you can appreciate all the architecture and the age of everything, it just makes it so cool and unique and enjoyable. There's just all this stone and brick everywhere, and everything's got like all these vines growing on it. I just love it so much. We found the pigs. They're so excited.
Oh my goodness.
What are you guys doing?
Oh my goodness.
We don't have any food for you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Those piggies might be really dirty, but they are really cute. So now the plan is to get ourselves a proper, delicious English breakfast.
Oh,
we've only
yeah.
had it once since we've gotten to England, but it's
I didn't
one of
even
our favorite things.
It. You had eat. It.
Yeah, that's true. But we found a place that has a vegetarian full English breakfast. So our idea was that we'll go there and she'll get the vegetarian one, and then I'll see if they have just a meat one, and we'll kind of compare and see how much better mine is.
Can't compare sausage to zucchini, man.
That's true. I mean, zucchini just so full body, that has so much flavor. All right, we're off.
We are off. And one thing to note about York is that apparently parking downtown is almost impossible or very expensive. So they do these park and ride locations where you just leave your car and there's a bus that comes like every 10 minutes or so. And I think it's about a little less than £3 a person. So we're gonna try that today and see how it goes.
We keep on getting busted by not having cash. If you didn't catch our previous videos, our debit cards stopped working because our bank shut them off because they issued us new ones randomly and didn't tell us. So we can't get out any cash. So the single day tickets you have to pay on the bus, and they're cash only. Luckily, we found a kiosk down the road that would take a card payment for just the one day ticket.
Yes.
So crisis averted.
Yeah, it's important to know though that that ticket office closes at 1 p.m. and it is almost that, so we almost didn't make it, but it all worked out.
All right, York, here we come. Breakfast, here we come. So we've went to the Visit York store, we've picked up our York passes, now we're heading to our lunch spot. The York passes should give us 10% off there, so that's one of the reasons we picked this place.
So, slight update. The place we were going to stop serving breakfast at 11:30, and so we had to figure out plan B. So we were walking down the road, and we actually found this adorable little coffee shop. It's called Spring, and it's funny because I found a list of like the 30 best coffee shops in all of Britain, and this one was one of them here in New York. So we just happened in here, and then I was like, this sounds familiar. And look, it's so cool.
Did you get a latte?
I did. Got a latte. You stuck with your cappuccino.
Yep. Cappuccinos are my jam, and she put just a little sprinkling of a cocoa powder on there. Quick history lesson. York is actually an incredibly old city. It was founded by the Romans in 71 AD. And it's also a walled city. It has some of the longest stretches of intact walls of any city in England.
Yeah, and it has some of the best preserved structures, I guess, in all of Europe, we hear. Also, York is known for their chocolate, so if you have a sweet tooth, this is the city for you.
To give you a sense of the general vibe of the city, yes, it's a little bit dreary, the weather isn't that great, it's cloudy in the sky, but there's so many people around and there's all these Christmas decorations everywhere and tons of shops and awesome stuff to check out. So it kind of has this really happy and festive vibe. It's almost like a city inside of a snow globe.
Our first official stop with our York Pass is up here to Clifford's Tower. Apparently this guy is 900 years old. So we're gonna head up and check out the view.
I need a weapon.
Don't shoot me.
It's only 4 p.m. and it's already dark here, you guys.
It's pretty insane.
It takes some getting used to.
We keep talking like, oh, we should probably start thinking about heading back because it's probably like 8 o'clock. No,
yeah.
Just 4.
But we're just kind of exploring the town and checking out all the Christmas lights. Every street has like a different pattern of lights strung up. And they also have all kinds of markets and stalls, and it seems to pretty much go on forever. So there's tons of stuff to see and smell, and they don't have nearly as many food options as we thought they would. I think the market's more about like trinkets and things like that.
Yeah,
but
like
they do have a few
candies and fudges and then homemade stuff.
Yeah, but we did find a place with some delicious looking meats cooking that I think we're gonna hit up later. We found this huge tent that they put up that's super cozy. They have like a fire burning back there, and it turns out they have all the stuff we were desiring. Hot cocoa, hot cider. They're out of mulled wine, sadly, but we've had a lot of mulled wine, so I feel like we should get something else. I think I'm gonna stick with the hot cider for sure. We got in at the right time because there is a huge line for the bar now. Found an open spot around the fire. All right. Oh, this is cozy. All right, time for a taste test. So we put the mint liqueur in there, right?
Yes. It tastes like an after-dinner mint, kind
Does
of,
it?
Like the chocolatey
That's
one.
That's what I was hoping for.
Oh man, it's sweet and amazing.
Yeah. Oh baby, that's like a delicious melted mint chocolate delight. Oh yeah, that is off the chain.
Oh yeah.
Dude, it's not even like too sweet.
No.
It's pretty sweet, but it's not that bad.
The mint, that takes it to a new level. I might be just adding mint to hot chocolate forever now,
yeah.
Even if it's not alcoholic.
This is the hot cider. I don't think we've had any cider in general yet since we've gotten here. Oh, it's real hot. Oh yeah, the flavor's really subtle in there. Yeah. It's really not, I mean, it's a little sweet, but it's got like a little like sugar and spices and stuff in there.
Yeah.
Not bad. I mean, the hot chocolate is, you know, it's so much more flavorful and intense than this, so I should have probably tried this first.
Bummer.
Still good though.
Oh,
little stand called Shambles Kitchen. They have one of these sausage swings on top of a fire roasting, and they told us that all of the sausages here were actually imported from Sweden. They went out and like hand-picked them, hand-crafted them, and then brought them back.
Yeah, everything's been like, you went over there, picked it all, made it all, and brought it back.
So. Wow, cool. Yeah.
The whole place is starting to shut down. We couldn't really find a spot to chill and eat our giant
no.
hot dogs.
Well, we found a place, but it also is a little rainy, so everything's soaking
yeah,
wet.
Yeah, everything's really wet. So we're just going to stand here and give these suckers a try.
Yeah, so also, we were just going to split one, and they completely misunderstood and gave us two. So...
But we're not mad about it.
No. That's a lot of hot dog to eat. So we got it Scandi style, I think. So mine has crispy onions, dill, some cranberry sauce and sour cream and relish.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Things that I would never in my life have thought to put on a wild boar sausage.
Now that's a bite right there.
That sausage is amazing. It's peppery, so it's really nice to go with all the sweetness up there. And I don't know, the flavors, like, I want to not like it because they're all so crazy, but I do like it a lot.
There's kind of a weird, interesting vibe out here. It's a little creepy. Everything's kind of shut down, and the wind keeps whipping up like a storm's coming, and then you have this, like, Christmas music just kind of emanating through the entire town.
But maybe it's also because we watched Krampus last night, which is, like, a Christmas horror movie.
Yeah, it's an amazing movie, by the way.
It's so funny. But maybe that's, like, making us, like, who's gonna... What little gingerbread man is gonna hop out and kill us?
Also, my lens is getting all wet because it's raining out here. But I think we're going to leave you guys here on the streets of York while we finish our delicious hot dogs. These things really are badass.
They're so good.
I think we made the right call.
Yeah.
But if you guys are new to our channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can see more videos like this. And hit the like button to let us know that you enjoyed this video. And yeah, we're going to be coming at you with more scenes of York in our upcoming videos.
We'll be right back here tomorrow exploring more. We just did a little exploring
today.
Yeah,
there's so much more to see here, you guys.
So much more. All right, good night, adventurers.
We'll see you on the road.